Electrophilic aromatic substitution is a reaction that replaces one of the hydrogen atoms on benzene with a group. Before we show the arrow pushing mechanism, let's dive into the reaction flask and see what's going on in there. When benzene and bromine are mixed, they'll move around in solution by diffusion, sometimes bumping into each other. But these molecular collisions are not going to be productive. They won't cause a reaction. Bromine is simply not powerful enough, not positive enough, to make benzene react with it. However, if we add in an iron catalyst, this can associate with the bromine, building up positive charge on it. Now, when benzene bumps into this activated bromine species, it can react. One of the double bonds becomes shared in a new bond with bromine and forms a carbocation on benzene. Now, one of the bromine atoms can dissociate from the iron complex, leaving as Br-. This deprotonates the molecule, neutralizes the carbocation, and forms bromobenzene. Now, let's show this mechanism with conventional arrow pushing. Benzene uses its double bond to attack activated bromine, and the Br- that's displaced forms a new bond with iron. Now, the drive for this compound to become aromatic again is so great that we can show a spontaneous deprotonation and just write minus H plus under the arrow. This reaction is general, so anytime benzene encounters an electrophile that is powerful enough, it'll open up its double bond attacking it. We can then show the electrons pushing back into the ring, and if we'd like and have an appropriate conjugate base in solution, we can use that to do a deprotonation. This gives us our substituted aromatic ring. Now that we've looked at the general electrophilic aromatic substitution mechanism, let's look at the possible electrophiles that we can add to an aromatic ring. We already saw the addition of bromine, and equivalents of Cl+ can also be used to react benzene. This reaction is halogenation. The nitronium ion can react with benzene in the nitration reaction. This gives a nitro derivative. Sulfonation of benzene can be accomplished using sulfur trioxide in a solution of sulfuric acid. The acylium ion shown here can also be attacked by benzene. This ion has resonance with a carbocation that makes it more obvious how benzene will attack. The reaction results in the addition of an acyl group to benzene and is called Friedel-Craft's acylation. Finally, some benzene derivatives can react with carbocations. This reaction gives alkylated derivatives and is called Friedel-Craft's alkylation. Benzene is a relatively stable molecule. However, when it encounters a powerful enough electrophile, it will undergo electrophilic aromatic substitution. We've also seen the five major benzene derivatives that we can form by reactions with different electrophiles, but we haven't yet looked at how those electrophiles are made and the conditions under which these reactions occur. We'll do that in a specific lesson for each reaction. Thanks for watching.